It is ginger ale with sherbet.
Yes.
And Hawaiian punch.
I remember you doing that. It was blue.
Yeah. He would make the red kind. The reason we did blue is because it was a baby boy.
Right.
And that was our New Year's Eve every year. And I always dreaded New Year's Day because there was a lot of football on TV.
Ugh. Yeah. It's not an NFL, usually.
No.
It's college.
It was
boring.
The only day of the year my dad would watch college football. And he'll tell you that to this day. It's the only day of the year he will. Speaking of my father, going off topic, as I was coming out of work tonight, I noticed that he commented on something on my Facebook. Does that, like, freak you out when, like, your uncles, aunts, anyone in your family above your age comments on your Facebook?
No.
I'm like, oh, crap, what did he say this time?
No. The people that I am friends with that are on Facebook, we get along really well, so okay. I don't expect them to just say something really
lucky.
Crazy.
My dad's so random. Like, it'll be a picture of my cat, and he'll be like, did you see what happened in Springfield today? Under the picture. And I'm like, Dad, you don't get Facebook. I love you. Just send me a text message.
Now, I have seen my husband's grandmother do weird stuff.
Crap.
But she doesn't usually stalk me or anything, so.
My dad is very sporadic, very random, maybe once or twice a year. Back on topic, New Year's resolution. Do you have one?
Yeah.
Thinking about,
you know, changing myself. Well, not changing, but, you know,
you
working.
Get a nose job? Could dye your hair purple?
No, that I might do, but I think that's against the rules at our company.
It is.
So, which is sad. Just trying to think about doing things differently.
For yourself?
Me and others.
Nice.
I had a list, but I forgot that one to bring. But I did think about it.
It is kind of a reset button. Like, I think a lot of hype is around the whole resolution thing.
Mm-hmm.
But it is kind of a reset. Like, you have a brand new year.
Mm-hmm.
Things are kind of lumped in together. Like, oh, remember back in 2005? So it's like a brand new year.
Right.
So back in 2015, what you going to look back on? I want to have more fun this year than I did 2014. I feel like I took life a little bit too seriously in 2014.
I understand. I've been a little bit too serious, too, and that's why I'm thinking I got to rethink about what I'm doing. So what else are you going to do?
I quit smoking last year. It's been a year. Yay me. But since then, I've turned to sugar instead of nicotine. So I'm going to cut the sugar back. And I've started already, and it's going quite well, except for those chocolate-covered cherries in the office. Min Min.
What are you talking about?
She brings my favorite cheap-ass chocolate-covered cherries in the office. My grandmother loved them. I would give her a box every year, the big 24-pack, and she would have one a day. I'm
for
like
24 days.
I would have like five a day. It's so ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to try and cut the sugar.
That's a good idea. I need to do that too. I'm not going to call it a diet though, because
no.
I always say that and it never happens.
I know. I just want to eat healthier. That's my goal. I think I said that last year, and I started out well, and then stress happened. I jumped off the sugarcane truck. I did want to talk about a restaurant that Steve and I went to this weekend. New to us. It's probably not new to Denver. It's on 17th Avenue, where they're developing a lot of new restaurants, it seems. It's called P17. On their website, it's described as your neighborhood bistro serving food and drinks inspired by the seasons. Our menu said fall 2014.
Okay.
So they changed their menu based on the season. Our kitchen makes everything from scratch and sources the freshest ingredients available. Enjoy a soul-warming bowl of soup, gather with friends over a selection of small plates and wine, or sit for a casual family dinner. Whichever you decide, we invite you to enjoy our hospitality in the company of friends and loved ones. And Steve and I split everything there. We got duck meatballs, which were amazing. We got mussels, which were amazing. He got a chicken sandwich, which was made out of a chicken thigh, which is my favorite part of the chicken. I know it's the least healthiest. It was amazing. And then we had this duck pasta mix, which was, again, amazing. Very saucy. And I had a mule with gin, and I recommend it. It's on 1600 East 17th Avenue, and it's called P17. And they have awesome patios, so in the future, when it warms up, I think we'll be back to try out the patio and try out their summer menu. Have you eaten at any good restaurants lately?
Longhorn Steakhouse.
Which is new in South Denver.
New in South Denver. It's not a, you know, it's a chain, but we hadn't gone, and we just happened to go at lunchtime, and that was reasonably priced at lunchtime.
Okay. Is it not at dinner time?
Dinner time looked pretty pricey, but it was really, really good food, and the service was awesome.
What did you have for lunch?
Daryl had a flat iron steak.
Okay.
Thought it was awesome.
Okay, good.
And then I had steak. And I went ahead and had the burger on in honor of my son.
Okay.
So I could tell him how wonderful it was.
Oh, so it was just you and Dare.
Just
Dar.
Dar.
Dar. I don't know why I called him Dare.
Because he's daring.
He's daring. Flat iron steak at lunch.
Yeah, that's right. Trying a new restaurant. And they also had corn fritters as an appetizer.
Ooh, what's that?
It's deep fat fried corn in batter.
Yummy.
Growing up in Oklahoma, it was a sweet corn batter.
Okay.
If you've ever gone to White Fence Farm out in Lakewood, it's a chicken place. Yeah, people come from everywhere to go there.
I need to go there.
And usually have to have a, you know, wait to get seated.
Do they take reservations?
I think they do.
Okay.
But anyway, they serve corn fritters, but they serve them with coated in powdered sugar.
Oh,
so
yum,
they're
yum.
Extraordinarily sweet.
Too sweet?
I thought they were too sweet because I was expecting my grandmother's recipe. Because everything else was more like her recipes
there.
At Longhorn Steakhouse, they were spicy.
Really?
Yeah. And it was good. It was a good
Colorado,
spice.
Colorado, they want to add spice to every dang thing.
Everybody wants Tex-Mex.
I guess.
Or some kind of twist of it.
I don't. I'm good.
You don't like the spice.
I don't like spice. No.
So it was
really Longhorn good. Steakhouse.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I will have to check it out. It's on my radar. I have seen it, but Steve's not a steak fan, so the likelihood of us going together is slim to none.
But he
travels frequently.
Right. Well, check their menu and see if there's anything else.
I'm sure. I love steak. Like, I love steak. If I go to dinner without Steve and steak is on the menu, I will likely get it. We are going to do the cliche end of 2014 show by going over some things from 2014.
Sounds like a plan.
And I found these lists. These are not original lists. Nope, not at all. But I found them, and I found them to be interesting. They're not your boring list. So the first one is the most overrated things in 2014. And I totally agreed with this list.
Go for it.
At number one is the Miley Cyrus dance called the twerk. I wish we had a video camera. Mindy just danced. That was awesome.
Yeah, but I didn't move my booty like her.
No, I don't think I could.
That is overrated.
It has been deemed the most overrated thing in 2014. And if you don't know what twerking is, you probably lived under a rock this year. But it's a raunchy dance move made even more famous thanks to a certain MTV VMA performance with Miley Cyrus and Robin Thicke back in 2013. The second most overrated thing in 2014, selfies. I have been taking selfies for many, many years, and the fact that they got a title really messed up my world, because now I feel a little guilty every time I post a selfie. I post at least once a week a selfie, sometimes twice. On my staycation, it was like once every day.
That was okay. It was fun.
It's a vain.
But at least you're not seeing the camera when you do it. Most of the other selfies, you see the camera because they're taking it in the mirror.
Oh, I have done, like, when I want to show my outfit, I do that.
That's rare.
Or I'll do it this way and I'll cut out my arm. Silly selfies. So that was the second most overrated thing.
Mm-hmm.
Other things that were overrated in 2014, Google Glass. What's that, Mindy?
It's glasses.
Okay.
That are high tech with your computer kind of stuff all in where you can see it when you're, it's very high, you know, if you watch any sci-fi, it's like having your computer right there in your glasses so you can see things written on the glasses, but
how
no one else can
like
see it.
Walk and stuff? Like you would have to be sitting to do this, right?
They say
how
you
do
can
you
do
type?
It. They say you can do it. I do not own any.
Do you know anyone that does?
Actually, no.
Me either.
I'm surprised we don't.
I know, right?
But I know one person.
Who?
Mario. But he's an Apple person.
Is he?
But he might if it was cool
enough. I bet he knows someone that does.
Oh, I bet he does. He's got a lot of cool techie things.
The iPhone 6 Plus, which I love my iPhone 6 Plus. Love it. Love it. I know you're not an Apple person or an iPhone person. I'm not really an Apple person. Look at my computer. It's totally PC.
It's okay. I still
love
you.
But I love my iPhone. The booty, it seemed like every other song that came out in Top 40 was all about the booty.
Mm-hmm.
Like the Anaconda song from Nicki Minaj, the booty song from J-Lo.
But there really are always tons of booty songs. It just depends on who's singing it.
I feel like they all came out at once this year, though. Like I think it was the Video Music Awards this year, and I was like, dang, there's a lot of booty songs.
But they're all copying others. I mean, like Black Eyed Peas did one with Fergie. I can't remember the name, Bootylicious or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember the song off the top of my head, but she had a song, had songs either with Black Eyed Peas or when she was doing her solo album that's all about
the bootay.
Yes.
I'm not a boutet person, so I'm jealous. Cronuts. Have you had a cronut?
No, I had to go look that one up.
What? Steve didn't know what a cronut was either. How do I know what a cronut is? It's a cross between a croissant and a donut. Started in 2013, and I have not seen them. I bet they're here somewhere, because Denver is such a foodie place.
There's got to be, because there's places where you can go and buy a hamburger on a donut.
Yeah, yeah, Krispy Kreme.
No, this is it's called Crave, and their hamburgers are, the bread is actually donuts.
I just said I was going to be healthier. Let's not talk about this stuff. Next!
Okay, next.
Avocado toast, that seems healthy. I've not heard of this, but it sounds really good.
Well, you had avocado eggs the other day.
I did. Oh, yum, yum.
I got to do that.
You do. Everyone was dyeing their hair pastel. We can't do that at work, so I had clip-ins for a while this year.
I wonder if we could dye underneath and no one would see.
They would see it. They're hawks.
That's true.
They've got their eye on us. The lob, also known as long bob, and that's been later this year. A lot of the celebrities have been chopping their hair off for that long bob.
Yeah, not so good.
And then gluten-free food, which I have a lot of friends that are gluten, like they can't eat gluten. So the fact that that was overrated kind of made me sad, because some people really can't eat gluten. Kathy Lewis can't eat gluten.
Yeah, there's a few. There's
Nick, we used to work with, couldn't eat gluten. It would kill him.
Right. But a lot of the stuff that they were saying it would do for those that weren't severely allergic to it,
right,
was not really accurate. Right.
They made it seem like a bad diet. And I don't think it was. It was just a lot of people realized that that was their issue, was gluten. Some memorable moments in 2014. We already talked about yours, your most memorable moment,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm. And yours?
Mine. I didn't prepare for this. I'm not used to the question being turned on me.
Ha.
Most memorable moment in 2014.
I think your staycation was probably a good
that
thing.
That was pretty amazing. Mm-hmm. I gotta say, I did a staycation last week. I only worked Monday, the week of Christmas, and the rest of the week I stayed home, and it was really amazing. It was probably the best vacation I've had all adult life, outside of Hawaii. You can't top Hawaii. But it was amazing. There was no stress, no packing, there was money spent, but not a lot of money. Like, it was, like, relatively cheap. And it was so relaxing just to sleep in my own bed, sleep in a little bit. Steve was home the whole time, and we had so much fun. We tried the world of vlogging, and you'll have to check out Wrinkled Sheets on YouTube, because that's where you'll find our vlogs. So yeah, you're right. That was my best moment all year. That's crazy.
Mm-hmm. And yeah. It just happened.
It did. Maybe that's why it was like, I'm still super happy. I had a little bit of a stomach bug at the end of it, but now I'm back to 100%, and that was the most amazing time. I would do it again today.
It'd be a good thing to do.
So some memorable moments from 2014. Ray Rice, he was caught by a security camera in an elevator. The impact of his violent rage against his then-fiancée was not lessened by our having seen it 87 times. Facebook, Twitter, all of the news sources.
Over and over.
The power of television did spark a national conversation on domestic abuse, which is probably a good thing.
Right. Long overdue.
Speaking of Barbara Walters, she left The View this year after a 6-decade career in broadcasting. She called it quits, but she still does her specials, like Most Interesting People of 2014. The whole Cosby thing, what do you think of that? I don't want to get all serious, because this is fun.
It's been going on. It seems like that controversy has been going on for a long time, and nothing's ever come of it.
Right.
But it's been going on for a while.
You think it'll fade off again?
Possibly. You know, either he pays them off, or he has enough proof that...
Right.
Or the proof will come out either way.
Right.
So...
Hopefully he's innocent, because... Ferguson, Missouri, Staten Island... Michael Brown, Eric Garner, the videos displayed endlessly, again, allowed viewers to decide for themselves, and everybody and their brother was freaking rioting and picketing, and kids here in Denver were walking out of their schools to show protest for Ferguson, Missouri, which was silly.
Well, and then the cop that got nearly died in that particular incident.
Right.
I mean, he's still in intensive care, I think, or last time I heard he was in intensive care still.
There's been so much drama when it comes to that. And then we had a missing airlines flight, but they found it.
No.
Last week, there was a missing airlines flight, but they just found it.
Right, but it's not the famous one made by CNN.
But it made us think back to the famous one that CNN